This is a follow along stretch and mobility class. It's prop week. So if you have a resistance band, then grab one of those, that'll be grand. It doesn't need to be very strong, it's something you can stretch pretty easily. We're gonna use it a little bit at the beginning and at the end of the session. You can use a towel or a fixed broomstick or something like that. This is just a little bit of mobility for the shoulders, which we're gonna do, as I said, at the beginning to warm up and a little bit at the end to develop some stretches. Not essential, but if you've got one, that would be great. So we're gonna get nice and warm, we'll pick that up in a minute. We're gonna loosen up, this is gonna be about half an hour. We're gonna work through some nice, simple mobility developmental stretches and see how you feel. As always, make sure you're doing things within your range of movement. Feel comfortable, develop it if you can. If you're not sure before taking part, please let me know. Okay, so standing in a nice, comfortable position with our feet close together, we'll take some little reaches. We're gonna breathe in and lift high. And circle your arms around. This is nice, easy movement for the shoulders. Keep your hands close together, lift them high. Circle them around. So a nice big lift. One more of those. Lifting high, we're gonna stay up this time. Pushing up high with the hands, set your feet apart slightly, and then we'll go nice and wide with your feet and turn your toes out. Reaching high with the hands. Now, as they come down to the side, I want you to fold just to halfway. Let them hang here. If you can touch the floor just with the fingertips, then tuck the chin in. We're going for a flat back, so you're parallel with the floor here. So our position is here. Don't need to be touching. If you're folding here, we want to be coming up a little bit. So hands just touching, we're just hanging. Okay, round the back and unfold. Bring your arms high again, lift up. Pushing high. Slowly fold, bring the arms down. Come to that flat back position and just hang. You should feel the backs of your legs stretching a little bit. Tuck the chin in. Unfold, we roll up. One more time, lift high. Pushing up high. Arms come out wide as we fold to halfway. Walk those feet in and just gently let your body hang. Just go to where it's comfortable. If it feels good, we'll just drop in a little deeper. A slight knee bend if you need it, otherwise straight legs. Okay, slowly unfold. Let's get the hips and glutes nice and warm. So standing, one foot, lift the knee, open, and circle. That's a lift and a circle of the knee. All the weight on this standing leg. Spread your feet and your toes out so that you can really find balance. And just open and roll. Lift and roll the knee, nice and easy. A couple more to do on this side. Last one. Good. Find your balance. Spread the toes. Lift and open. So a nice little roll of the knee. Really mobilizing that hip joint. If you need to hang on to something, that's fine. But just take your time just to mobilize. Couple more to go. Nice and steady. Okay, we're going to grab your little resistance band or towel or something that you can use to reach overhead with. Fairly wide with your hands, have your feet close together. We're gonna lift from here up high and just take it over the head to start with. Doesn't need to go too far, so from here to here, lifting it overhead. This is gonna depend on your shoulder and chest flexibility and mobility, and that's what we're here to try and help develop. With a band, what will happen is it will stretch a little wider. When you reach the point when your shoulders don't like this, then you must stop, but if it feels like you can go a little further, the band will stretch and you'll allow those arms to go further. But it feels comfortable and you know you can do it, we're going to go all the way straight away to here. Move away from the wall. So we touch at the front and we touch at the back, letting those shoulders roll. Now you'll see if I hold this band, my arms start to stretch a little wider as I do it. The more mobile we'll get and more stretch we get, the straighter the arms will stay. It's much harder with a fixed towel or a post or a pole or whatever. So try it with a resistance band if you can. Just a few more of these and we're going to come back to them and develop them shortly. So a couple more. Last one, should start to feel nice in the shoulders. Okay, we're gonna bring that up and over, and then we're gonna bring it onto your back. So from here, it's resting against your back. Leaning forwards, keeping those arms there, tuck the chin in. Step your feet wide, and we're gonna just do a nice little twist side to side. So just a little one, back to the middle. And twist. If it feels uncomfortable in the shoulders, there's too much tension, you can do this without the resistance band, that's fine. What we're trying to do is keep the arms straight through the body here. So rather than coming down and dropping this hand, we keep it up. Twist with relaxed. That's nice. Little movement for the mid-back. Strength in the upper back as we move. Start to develop the range of movement if you can. A little knee bend is fine. A couple more. And rise. Feet close together. Let's go and develop this by bringing your hands further in if you wish. It's up to you. We're going to roll those arms over. So that's found a challenging level for me now. A little bit closer. The band will stretch a little bit to allow my shoulders to go. One side might feel a little tighter than the other, but just find balance in your movement, nice and controlled. A few more to go now. We're working with some nice mobility. We'll get rid of that and we'll come back to it later. Shake it out. We're going to take a nice lunge position now. So we've dropped one foot to the floor, back knee down. So make sure we've got width between the feet. We're not right in front of the knee. There's a little width here. And we're just going to sink in gently and then come back. Now we're not bouncing. We're just bending that knee over the ankle. You can go a little further if you wish as well. And then we push back. So dropping in nice and steadily. We've got a few moves to do from here. We're going to be here for a little while, so make sure you've got something comfortable underneath your knee. We're just bending nice and steadily into that front knee. We're going to hold this time. So as the knee is over the ankle or just a little further forward, you should feel hip flexor stretch here. You might feel glutes stretching a little here, depending where it's tight. Sink in, keep the torso lifted for now, and just breathe. So we're going to lunge, we're going to lower, we're going to lift, and we're going to lean. We've got lots to do down here. So this is our lunge and then we're going to lower. So I want you to try and bring your hands down to the inside of the foot if you can. So hands come down to the floor. If that feels uncomfortable, you can come back up to the knee. But if you're okay, we stay down here. More advanced option if you can. The opposite elbow is going to come towards the floor, sinking in. And we're trying to drop the hips down with this. We don't want the bum and the back to be right up here. So just go as far as you feel is comfortable. Gonna drop in gently. If you know you can do it, you want to try, we're going down to both forearms. That's gonna be a bigger stretch in your hip flexors and your back and your glutes. We're gonna breathe. This is our lean. Let's stay in nice and low. Choose a level that feels right for you. And when it feels good, we're going to come back gently. Hand onto the knee. Come up tall with the opposite hand now. Sinking in still. Let this hand come to the side. We take a lean to the side now. Fingertips towards the floor. So you're leaning towards this front knee, but we're fairly tall with the torso. Okay, so we're sitting upright and we lean across to the side. Just take your time and breathe. Develop that stretch a little bit so go as low as you feel comfortable. If you want to come back at all, you can come back. Breathe. Okay, let's repeat. We come down with the hands to the inside. Bring that foot across so you've got a little space for your body. When you feel ready, forearm, then the other forearm if you can. Keep the knee tucked in and breathe. Come back up, hand to knee, lift, sink a little deeper now if you can, lean a little further now if you can. Oh look, the fingers touch the floor a bit easier now, we're warming up. Gently release. Now before we change sides, we're going to add a little challenging stretch for this back leg. So stay in your position. I'm going to move around so you can see. We're going to bring this back foot towards you. Now this is where your little resistance band or towel might help again. If you need it to put it around the foot and take it, if you can hold here, then hold here and gently pull in. So the elbow goes high and we just pull that foot towards you gently. Big quad and hip flexor stretching this leg at the back here. So breathe. Develop that stretch. Let's hold strong. Should feel nice. Let's breathe. What about a hint of your love? Start to shake. Start to shake. A few more seconds to hold. Settle your breathing and hold that position. Gently release. If that's too much for you with that pull, then don't worry, we can do one lying down on your front with the band a bit later. Okay, let's take the other leg forwards. Just take your time to sink into that position. It's going to feel a little tighter in this side from what you've just done. So we come in gently and then back. And do it again, nice and steady. Lunge lower, lift and lean. Nice and controlled. Sink in and hold this time. So knee just over the ankle, a little further forwards, okay? Sink in so you feel that hip flexor stretch and breathe. Hanging in there nice and strong. When you feel ready, bring hands towards the floor. Again, make sure you've got space. There needs to be a gap here for your body to come down to. When it feels comfortable or you feel ready, take the forearm and take the other one. Sinking, bringing the knee in, dropping down with the back and the hips. Breathe. Touch the hands down, hand to your knee, and lift. Take the lean. Let's breathe and hold. Undo the lean and we're going to repeat coming forwards. So hands down, nice and steadily. Take your time and then sink in. Nice and relaxed. Big stretches, let's breathe and hold. Hands touch down, hand to knee, lift high. And then lean a little further if you feel you can. Hand comes back, reach for the foot. Take hold, elbow high, pull in gently. Let's breathe. Oh, find that deep stretch in the quads and hip flexor, that's nice. Hang in there, let's breathe. Okay, we're gonna stay in this lunge position now. Just reset slightly so that you can turn the toes at the back and push them down. I want you to bring arms up high. And this is your first option here. So we're trying to keep the shoulders relaxed down. Arms as high as you can, close to the side of the head, but don't reach up here. I want you retracting those shoulder blades. Now from here, if you can, we're just gonna push the back leg straight. So the big stretch out through that back leg and a bit of strength going on in the quads and the glutes. Sink in deeply, reach your arms high, tummy muscles drawn in. If it's too much, you can have that back knee down, but work on the shoulder movement, back and down, straight arms. Okay, gently release, knee touches down, and we'll switch leg. And slide it back, set it up, lift your arms, shoulders back and down, up onto the back foot so the knee lifts. We breathe and hold. Stay strong, stay still. Arms down, knee down. Good, let's breathe. Okay, I want you to sit yourself down. Get hold of your resistance band or your towel. We sit nice and tall with the body. You're going to wrap this over the feet. So I want you to flex your feet. So the opposite from pointing your toes, flex your feet. And then we're just going to wrap that around, right around the middle of the foot, and sit nice and tall to begin. So what we're trying to do is pull your legs back. So we're pulling the back so that your bum goes a bit further back underneath you. And we sit tall, draw the tummy in gently. A little pull on that. Now this is where actually a fixed towel is better, because you will get that better pull rather than it bouncing like this. Now if you don't need this and you can reach your feet, then that's fine. But if you need this, then bring it over your feet. And all we can do is pull your body in gently. Now you're in control, your range of movement. Don't push it. If your back feels no good or your hamstring's tight, then just go to where it feels okay. If you can, we pull in gently and breathe. Now, if you don't need that, then you can reach for those toes. Then get your hands over the feet, pull back, chest lifted, then let the chest lower. So sinking in, finding your level, breathing. Use that band if you need it, otherwise pull that a little bit more with your hands on your feet, sink in and breathe. Now you might not be where I am, you might be much further up, but this here is going to help you pull in just to give that little bit of a stretch. You take your time and find your level and breathe. Okay, gently release. You're going to lie straight onto your back from here, so bend the knees, lie onto your back, point the toes now, and let's bring the knees in. We're going to circle. Do a little bit of glute stretching. Now that we're nice and warm in those hamstrings, let's circle the other way. We're going to challenge our lower back, mid-back, and glutes. So arms out wide, roll your knees down to one side, just gently. If they can come all the way to the floor, that's great. I want you to let your head look the opposite way to the knees. Top foot comes up to the side of the leg. This hand can gently pull. We're trying to keep the shoulder down. If your shoulder lifts here, then you found your range and just hold that stretch. If you can keep it down and look along that arm and give a gentle pull here, you should feel a big stretch through your mid-back and into your glutes a little bit here. Okay, gently release. Arms are wide. Roll the knees the other way. Shoulders are down. Hip on the floor and hold. Look down the opposite way to your knees. Extend. Gentle pull down. Good. Gently release that. Bring the knees up again. Let's give them a little circle. That should have felt nice and comfortable. Back the other way. Okay, I want you to turn your soles of your feet to the ceiling. Have your knees apart and bend. Reach your hands to the inside of your feet here. So soles of the feet facing the ceiling, hands reach to the inside, and we pull knees down towards your armpits. Looking up, and a little pull down there and hold. We can rock gently side to side here as well. Should feel a big stretch in your hamstrings, in the hips a little bit, lower back maybe. Just breathe and hold. Gently release. Okay, find yourself up onto your front again. We're going onto hands and knees, and we're going to continue with this back mobility. So knees apart, equal weight between hands and knees. And we do a gentle reach through. We're not holding this, it's going to be a mobility one. We're going to reach. As soon as you get as far as you can go, we're going to come back slowly. So it's just thread the needle, push your hand through, shoulder, head touch the floor, go as far as you can, and then we come back. So mobility, reaching through, and then switching. One more each side. Nice and steady. Last one. Okay, from the position we're in here now, we hold on the hands and we walk the knees out as far as you can go. Now, if you can slide them out, even better. I want you to concentrate on flexing your feet. So knee bend at 90, flex your feet. So it's the opposite of pointing your toes. We flex them. Flex those feet and bring the knees as wide as you can. So feet are flexed, knees are wide. We're holding still here for now. Now, if you can drop down to your forearms, that's ideal, and your back is parallel with the floor. So knees wide. Feels uncomfortable, then come out of that position by pushing to one side. You feel a big stretch in your inner thighs, you're doing it right. Rest on the forearms, I want you to bring them back and then push your bum back. Whoa, that's gonna feel it. Let's breathe. Take your stretch, let's go once more. Hands come back, elbows back, then push the bum back, reversing back parallel with the floor. Let's breathe and hold. Hands touch down, step one knee in. From here, onto your knees, let's rise, breathe. Lift arms as we did before. Keep those shoulders dropped down and hold here. We're going to leave one arm up. We're going to turn the body and reach down towards the heel. Now, if you can't reach that, just in the back is fine. But reach for the heel. Now, we're going to lean. It's a little open of the hips. Reach up high. Again, if this is uncomfortable to come this far, come back a level. We're going to switch arms, so lift and reach back. Relax to the middle, palms facing facing in, fingers down and draw the shoulders back. Pushing the hips forward, a gentle back bend, squeeze those glutes. Now if it feels okay and you know you can do it, you want to try, we reach for the heels, both hands, shoulders back. Come back a level anytime you need to. Hands back to the hips. Stick the bum back into a child's pose, so we keep those knees apart, feet together, and reach hands out in front. Stretch them out as far as you can. So we're trying to keep our forearms, elbows off the floor, and reach your fingers further and further away. Okay, in a seated position that's comfortable for you, grab your resistance band or towel again, and we're going to do some little stretches for the shoulders, some mobility again. So we're going to reach up and over with one hand and then behind with the other. So if you can already link your fingers, that's fine, but what I want you to do is get close. If you can link, just get close. If you can't link, one over, one under there is where we're going to hold. So we're keeping that close link. It doesn't matter whether you are linked or not, how close you are. I want you to think about sitting tall, bringing this upper arm here. So we're nice and straight up, vertical with that top arm. Now my bottom arm here, I'm gonna pull down. Now because this is a resistance band, it's gonna stretch, your towel won't, it will pull you further. I want that to pull my top arm down a little further to increase that tricep stretch. So I'm creep the fingers together and then pull down with this bottom arm. I'm gonna turn around so you can see. So I'm actively pulling down with this arm and it's stretching that top one. I said a fixed towel will make it a lot more difficult. So now we're going to opposite, I'm going to push up. Keep my hands together a little and push up so this hand comes further up the back. So it comes further up the back as I reach high. That's a big shoulder stretch now. Let's do once more, pull down. And breathe. And again, push. Gently release, and then we're going to switch. So creep the hands closer together. Again, one side is going to feel easier than the other. This one's harder for me, so we'll try and creep my hands together. All right, now we're comfortable, we're close with the grip. I'm going to pull down on this bottom arm to really stretch out through this tricep. Stay nice and tall with the body, nice and balanced. Sit however it's comfortable for you. Now pushing up, getting those hands close together and then reaching. See, my hands aren't close together now because this band is stretching. You do it with a towel, your hands will stay close, but you'll really feel that stretch in the front of this shoulder. Once more, pull down. Actively help that stretch. Let's breathe. And then push up last time. Gently release. Alright, make your way to standing. With your band again, as we began, I'm going to see how that's done for our shoulders. So we're reaching high up and over. Should feel a lot looser than you did first time you did this. Reach up and over. Nice and controlled. Big circle up and over. Find your level. And if you can't go all the way, that's fine. You just take it as far as it feels comfortable. Okay, relax there. Get rid of that. Give the arms a little shake out. Give the legs a little bit of a shake out. We're going to take some breath and finish as we began. So breathe in and reach. Breathe out and circle those arms. And again, breathe in. And breathe out. One more time. And relax. Shake it out. Super stuff. I hope that was a useful stretch and mobility session for you. There's going to be a few bits in there that you would have found challenging, some things that will feel good. Make sure that you do things to your level, as I've said before. If you struggled with anything, please let me know. Give me a shout, drop me a message, send me an email, come and see me. I'm here to help you, and I look forward to seeing you soon.